When I heard about the potential case of honeybees dying because of hygienic behavior, I was shocked. I thought it might be a mistake or something. What is funny is that I immediately start to think about some beekeepers in Florida that control mites the same way they control American fowl brood, killing the whole colony. Hygienic behavior is a good habit to have. At the individual level, humans clear their hands, take showers, and clean the surroundings to avoid infections by viruses and other pathogens, which help at the social level with fewer infected individuals spreading diseases in the social group. In honeybees, the same principle is applied. There are many social immune behaviors with the same goal of humans, both at the individual and social levels. For example, grooming is a social immune behavior where bees clean themselves and other colony members. However, the term hygienic behavior in honeybees is defined as the ability of a honeybee worker to detect and remove dead, dying, and sick honeybee brood from sealed cells. Also help the social group eliminating potential diseases to spread. Interestingly, excessive hygienic behavior in humans can be detrimental. We know today that a strong immune system is developed by exposure to the right amount of pathogens at certain ages. Not less, not much. But what about the honeybees? Can excessive hygienic behavior be detrimental to them? The greatest pollinators of all time, the honeybee apes mellifera. The one that helps us to keep our food supply. The one that is so important that we have to keep, in the United States alone, around 2.5 million colonies to pollinate our crops, are facing several challenges in the last decades. The introduction of the disgusting bloodsucker mite, Varroa destructor, almost 40 years ago, messed up with the whole system. And honeybees are still adapting to the consequences of the introduction of this terrible mite. If you follow this channel for a while, you know that Varroa mite feeds on the fat bodies and hemolymph of honeybees, and in doing so, it not only depletes the honeybees of important nutrition resources, but also Varroa can transmit many viruses that can kill honeybees, including deformed wing virus, the one that caused malformations of the wings, as you can see right here. Pretty sad, right? Even sadder is the fact that only a few of my viewers are subscribers. But this is very easy to solve. Just click the like button and also click the subscribe button to help me to bring more videos about honeybees to everybody. Thank you. Researchers like myself and beekeepers are looking hard for ways to help the bees to overcome difficulties associated with Varroa mite, which includes malnutrition, pesticides, and pathogens. Because hygienic behavior is a heritable trait, not a learned behavior, some beekeepers perform genetic selection for this trait, meaning that their honeybee colonies are more hygienic than the average. Colonies selected to have more hygienic behavior seems to have no negative impact in their health. Until now. In April of 2021, researchers from the prestigious USDA Honeybee Research Laboratory in Beltsville, Maryland, published a scientific article that will make a lot of people rethink the concept of hygienic behavior and honeybee health, especially when we're talking about the Varroa mite-transmitted virus, deformed wing virus. This is a sick pupa being removed from its cell. Honeybees performing hygienic behavior can cannibalize part of the sick brood to recycle precious nutrition to the colony. This is a well-known procedure, and the researchers hypothesized that cannibalism could be a potential transmission pathway of viruses. It seems obvious, but in science, you must prove it. So, how did the researchers demonstrate the transmission? Using powerful molecular techniques to trace a fluorescence deformed wing virus infection, the researchers led by Dr. Francisco Posada demonstrated that cannibalization of deformed wing virus infected pupae resulted in high levels of these virus in worker bees that later on transmitted this virus to other colony members via trophallaxis, allowing circularization of deformed wing virus variants without mites. The results are very interesting, but even more interesting is how the research was done. First, the researchers collected young pupae and injected them with a genetically engineered fluorescent deformed wing virus that basically make the pupae become green if the virus starts to replicate in it. Then they let varroa mite feed on this green pupae to get the green virus. A couple of days later, they put this mite in a honeybee cells containing healthy brood so the mite could infect the healthy brood with this virus. The hive mite infestation in those cells triggers hygienic behavior, making worker bees from the colony find, open, and remove the sick brood, cannibalizing part of the brood in the process. And when the authors detected green viruses replicating in the worker bees after the brood removal, it was the proof they need to conclude that this dangerous transmission route occur naturally. Now that the researchers know that hygienic worker bees get infected, can these infected hygienic workers transmit the virus to other colony members? Two cages separated by a wire mesh. On one side, they put worker bees that cannibalized infected pupae and called them donor bees. And on the other side, they put worker bees that did not cannibalize any pupae and called them recipient bees. This setup allows the bees to be separated by this wire mesh, but still able to share food via trophallaxis. On day 11 of this experiment, the researchers were able to find the green virus activity in the bees that has never cannibalized infected pupae, demonstrating once and for all that the researchers were right. Hygienic behavior can spread deformed wing virus to the whole colony by cannibalism followed by trophallaxis. As a private consultant for the beekeeping industry, I visit and interacted with dozens of beekeeping operations every year. And each operation has its own protocols and ideas about how to handle bees. These new findings remind me of a client in Central Florida. In his operation, he's obsessed with controlling varroa, to the point that he kills the whole colony that crosses certain levels of infestation. His annual colony losses are very low, around 7 to 10%. And in his mind, economically speaking, it makes sense to eliminate a couple of colonies for the benefit of all others. I personally think it is an extreme measure, but this study about cannibalism and trophallaxis as a new virus spreading system make me think about his management system. Please keep in mind that I am not suggesting killing hives if you find varroa. I invite you here to think about these new findings, that's all. If the researchers in this study are correct, varroa might act more as a trigger of a virus infection cascade. Varroa might infest the hive, transmit viruses to some pupa, the hives defend itself, trying to remove infested brood, infecting worker bees because of hygienic behavior that leads to a widespread of viruses inside the hive via trophallaxis, making the bees the main spreader now. In an apiary, everybody knows, there are a lot of bees exchanging colonies all the time. Drifting is a well-known behavior and any beekeeper knows that. And here is the problem. Now we have a bunch of honeybees with their bellies full of viruses able to transmit them to new colonies, better than the mites themselves. Perhaps that's why eliminating the colonies might be working for this colleague in Florida. It doesn't help much to lower the levels of mite only because all bees in the colony will be infected and able to transmit the viruses to other colonies. Now beekeepers might have an explanation for some very weird colony losses with apparently no mites involvement. It is a very interesting way to see the problem in a clear case of how science can help us to figure things out that it will be impossible only observing the hives.
If you like this video, please consider supporting me on Patreon, where I post more content about bees and connect with my followers on a personal level.
And if you want to learn more about honeybees, please click the thumbnails at the screen right now.
Thanks for watching Inside the Hive.tv, the show about bees. See you guys next week.